Yes. Good morning, all students. Today's class will be now dealing how to solve a given problem by applying the Floyd's algorithm. Right? So this is the graph given to you. As I had told you earlier, they can give you a graph, right? Wherein the graph should be a directed and a weighted graph, compulsory. It should be weighted. Okay, and they may also sometimes give you the cost adjacency matrix. Then you will have to use that and construct the the intermediate matrices. Okay, so this is the graph which has been given to you. So we'll just find out the shortest path between every pair of vertices using Floyd's. So as I told you, it is quite much similar to Warshall's algorithm, wherein you will be generating the sequence of matrices, sequence of distance matrices. Okay, hope the PDF screen is visible, students. Yes, no, is it visible?
No.
Yes. Okay, so now let's say, given the following graph, how do we solve it? Right, so the solution goes like this. We need to obtain all pair shortest path matrix. Earlier it was just path matrix, now it is APSP, all pair shortest path matrix, for the above graph by generating sequence of matrices. So you can observe there are how many vertices here? 4 vertices, isn't it? So I should generate the matrices like this: D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, wherein 0 is your the normal cost adjacency matrix, and D4 will be your the all pair shortest path matrix. And remember, students, this numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 indicates the intermediate vertices. 1 means the first vertex acting as the intermediate, which is the first vertex for me here, A. 2 means the second vertex, B. Hope you are all getting, right? So you have to remember that convention. You might, what is this? Mom has given me 1. There's no 1 here. 1 means the first vertex, A. Okay? Step 1, as you all know, I have to first generate the matrix D0. Because through D0, I will get D1. From D1, I get D2. And you can also observe, to obtain D2, D1, D0 must be solved. Then it is a dynamic programming. The problems will be overlapping, as you all know. Okay. So we will generate the cost adjacency matrix of the graph, that is D0. And can I know the conventions for generating the cost adjacency matrix? If there is a edge, unmute and talk to me. Answer me. If there is a edge, what should you write? If there is a edge, what should you write in the cost adjacency matrix? Students. Yes.
Weight of the edge, ma'am.
We have to write the weight of the edge. If there is no edge?
Infinity, ma'am.
Infinity. And if there is no self loops? Self loops.
Zero, ma'am.
Right? Zero. Right? So, keeping that in convention, I will now construct the matrix. And you all know it is again a matrix of size n cross n. So, what is that n number of vertices? 4 vertices. A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D. And I will draw this. Write this. Are you understanding? Right? Now, using this, I'll have to construct the matrix D1. And you all know that D1 is a matrix that contains all the shortest path distance through the vertex A, the first vertex, that is A. If the graph is numbered with numbers, then it will be 1, remember. Okay, since we are considering the shortest path through the vertex A, we must consider which row and which column in D0, students? Which row and which column? Which row and which column should we consider in D0?
Fifth row and eighth
third eighth column. Very good. And you saw that in the earlier partials, we were considering only the entries, the pairs with entries. The pairs with entries?
1, 1.
But here, slight variation you can observe. Consider the pairs with entries non-zero and non-infinity. What does it mean? Non-zero, non-infinity means consider the entries which are not zero and which are not infinity. Which are the entries you should consider? Only the numbers, the weights you should consider. Are you understanding? Do not consider zero and infinity. Non-zero and what is that? Non-infinity. Are you understanding? Okay. And you know that K here is a vertex which is A now for me, isn't it? So we also know that D of ij is what? Min of D of ij comma D of ik plus D of kj. This relation we have to remember. Now, considering the above matrix D0, we have, we know that K is A. Tell me which is the first combination which I take? Which is the first combination? Which is the first combination, students? A, A column, A row. Which is the first combination?
B comma A, ma'am.
Combined with A comma?
C, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. That is the first combination. So you consider B comma, write down with numbering as bullets. Okay. Anything, whatever you feel comfortable. B of A equals to 2 and A of C equals to 3. So consider only the numbers. Do not consider 0 and infinity. Therefore, what is towards your LHS, students? What is towards your LHS? What should you write? I comma J. So from this, what is I comma J? What is I comma J? With these two pairs, what is I comma J?
B comma C.
Write down towards the LHS is equal to minimum of B comma C. Okay. I'm not writing this D anyways because I will be getting the entries from my matrix. Not a problem. Comma B comma A plus A comma C. Okay. What is this B comma C? Just observe here. What is this B comma C? B comma C is now what, students? Infinity. Stating that there is no path for me. B comma C, there is no path. The distance is infinity. Infinity. 2 plus 3. What is this 2 plus 3 now? 5. Minimum of infinity comma 5. What is this 5? Which is the minimum value? 5 for me. So B comma C, will, which was earlier infinity, now becomes 5 in D1. And what does this indicate now? There is a path from B comma C through which vertex? Through A, whose length is 5. Whose length is 5. As of now, we cannot tell it is the shortest. Only at the end I can know. But as of now, there is a path from B comma C which is equal to 5. Similarly, which is the next pair that I consider? The next pair, students. Speak out. The next pair for me.
B comma A and A comma C.
Yes, B comma A with A comma C. Right? You consider this. You should write this, the matrix. Right? D comma A is 6, A comma C is 3. Now what is towards your LHS? What is towards your LHS? D comma C. You might ask me, mom, how is it? This is nothing but I comma K. This is nothing but K comma J. So what is I comma J? That is D comma C. So write towards your LHS. Apply the recurrence relation. And you can see D comma C is infinity. There is no path. As of now, D comma C is infinity. Isn't it? So write it. 6 plus 3 is 9. The minimum value is 9 for me. So there is a path from D comma C which is equal to 9 in D1. So what should you do? The updated matrix D1 you will have to write, where BC is 5, so update BC 5 and DC is 9. The rest all is the same as of D0. Hope you are all getting, okay, 5 and 9, right? Similarly, now generate the matrix D2. So D2 will contain all the shortest path distance through the vertex B. So which row and which column should I consider in D1? D1, which row and which column? Students.
D row and D column.
And you can see the possibilities here. So you should mark this, otherwise you will not keep in track. So which are the two possibilities that we have? Two possibilities. The combinations. Well, first possibility, someone can tell me?
Mom, C comma B and B comma A.
B comma A. Then the next one.
Mom, C.
Yes, ma. Yes.
C comma B and B comma C, ma.
Yes, C comma B and B comma C. You can observe. C comma B and B comma A. C comma B and B comma C. And you can observe here, your LHS is CA and here it is CC. Earlier, you can observe CA is infinity, which now becomes 9, updated. Similarly, you can see here, CC is 0. And as I told you, the self loops, we are not finding out the shortest path. It is the same, whatever it is. No means it is 0. Are you understanding? See here, minimum is 0. We are not interested in finding the shortest path between the same set of vertices. Cycles we are not finding, between different pair of vertices we are finding. So 0 comma 12, minimum is 0. It remains the same. Okay, update the matrix again, D2, wherein only one is updated. CA, which was infinity, now becomes 9. I observing, right? Now again, generate D3. So I, as you all know, D3 is the shortest path distance to be covered to the vertex C, and I should consider C row and C column, right? And you can see there are almost how many pairs with C row and C column? How many pairs will you get? How many pairs?
Nine
pairs, okay? One with B, A comma C, done with C comma A, C comma B and C comma D, like that. So you will have 9 pairs. So you can see now, A comma C, done with C comma A, C comma B and then C comma D, right? So you can observe here, this is a self loop, it is 0, no problem. You can observe here, earlier it will be infinity, now becomes 10. Here you can also see AD, which was infinity, now becomes 4. Why? Because there is a shortest path from C vertex, right? And also you can see here, B comma A. See, B comma A, earlier it was 2. I think B comma A was 2. Earlier, but then you have the path through C, right? Path through C, I think, okay, here it should be B comma C with, this is B, okay, B comma C, this is typing mistake there. So this should be B there. B comma C plus C comma A. You can observe that it is 14. So 2 comma 14, whichever is minimum, you will return it. Same thing, right? So you can observe here, the all the 9 pairs you will have to update, right? So look it for the minimum values. Based on that, you will now generate the matrix T3. Yes, right? So you should be very careful when you are doing the pairs. So it will take some time, but you should be very careful in doing the pairs there. Okay, so this is the D3 matrix. Again, you have to consider the generating the matrix D4 through the vertex D as the intermediate vertex. So again, consider the Dth row and the Dth column. Again, you can observe here, there are again 9 pairs to be done, right? So again, you will have to consider each and every pair carefully. A comma D, D comma A. See, if there is a self loop, you can omit. Looking at this, you can know it is a self loop. You can omit that, not a problem, but be careful when you are omitting, right? And here also you can see A comma D, D comma B is A comma B. Okay, based on that, you can omit the self loops and take the other pairs. Okay, so like this, you will have to again deal with all the 9 pairs, right? And then generate the D4 matrix. And now you can just stop at this particular point of time because the last matrix is generated and the all pair shortest path matrix is your last matrix, that is D4. So D is equal to 0, 10, 3, 4, 2, 0, 5, 6, 7, 7, 0, 1, 6, 16, 9, 0. This is the shortest path matrix. Okay, see, I think in the last class I had asked you people to write shortest path matrix manually. Is it the same, students? Anybody who has done it? Is it the same? Or any differences you are finding, students? Anybody has tried doing it? Yes or no? Students? Anybody has tried doing that manually? Yes. Girish, is it the same? The answer is correct?
No, one.
Okay. Okay. So you just check me and tell me. So like this, you will have to generate the matrix. Okay. I have a question for you all. Sometime here in the last matrix, that is D, if there is infinity, what does it indicate? What does it indicate? In Gauss adjacency matrix, infinity indicates what? In Gauss adjacency matrix, infinity indicates what, ma? Students? Infinity indicates what in Gauss adjacency matrix?
Ma'am, there's no path between those two nodes.
No. In cost adjacency matrix. Cost. In D0, if I write infinity, it indicates what? There is? When do you write infinity in cost adjacency matrix?
When there is not a directed edge, ma'am.
There is no directed edge. Similarly, in your D matrix, that is in your D4, if there is infinity, it indicates that there is no edge or path. Last matrix I'm talking about.
Path, ma'am.
There is no path. If there is a path, some shortest distance will be there. If there is no path, it will have infinity. So this is one of you, there is a program for you in your lab. So they ask in the exam, what does infinity mean here? So you should not tell no edge, right? There is no path. Are you understanding? So you can see the verification to be also done with respect to the graph. So if you have the graph, you can also verify the graph there. The graph is... I think you can see graph A to B, the shortest path is 10, right? A to B, the shortest path is A to C, C to B, 7 plus 3, it is 10, right? A to C, it is 3. A to D is 4, yes, 3 plus 1 to the vertex C, right? You can just verify. B to C is 5, is it correct? B to C, the shortest path is 5, yes. Isn't it? Right? So like this, you can check it out in your graph, check whether your answers are correct or wrong. Hope you're all getting it. Right? Fine. That's about the Floyd's algorithm. That's how you have to exit. It will take some time, students, but carefully if you do, you will easily get 6 to 8 marks. Sometimes it will be 6, only the problem. Sometimes 8 marks asking you to write the algorithm also. Okay, so you can write that. Okay, then followed with that, you have the assignment. So I want you all to do this particular assignment. Okay, it is having 5 vertices, but you can practice. It's one of the question paper problem, only 2018 question paper problem. I've just given to you all. Okay. Okay, that's about the Floyd's algorithm. To tell you about the knapsack problem, as I had already told you, we are dealing with the knapsack problem wherein you have a bag, the items associated with weight and the profit. I have to fill the items in such a way that into the bag, we get a maximum profit such that the capacity of the knapsack does not exceed. So as I told you, we have 2 variants of knapsack problem. One is fractional knapsack problem, where I select the objects partially. So this fractional is solved by using greedy method. So in your exam, in module 3 also, knapsack problem will come. Module 4 also knapsack. But the approach of solving is different. So you should be careful when you are solving. Module 3 is greedy method. Module 4 will be your dynamic programming. Okay, and the dynamic programming is dealing with 0-1 knapsack problem. As I told you, 0-1 means either I can select the object completely or I should not select it. There is no partial selection, as I had told you, right? So as we have seen, the same thing we have given here, right? So we have to construct a table, as I discussed in the last class, which we call it as a profit table. And you all know profit table is made up of how many rows? N plus 1 rows with M plus 1 columns. N plus 1 rows, M plus 1 columns, where N is the number of objects, M is the capacity. And numbering, you will do it as 0 to N and columns with 0 to M. Are you understanding? Row, I will indice with I, which is the object, and J, the column, which is the capacity of the knapsack. So what does the entries in the table indicate? V of ij, as I told you, it indicates the optimal profit when the capacity of the knapsack is J and only the objects from which to which, object number 1 to I is considered. So I comma j means it is not only ith object. Remember students, first object to ith object. And the maximum profit will be placed at the last row and the last column, that is V n comma m. Right? So you can see this is a small example which is being dealt in this way. So your problem solving, now you have to construct this table step by step and show what is your last profit by selecting which objects. Are you understanding? So the recurrence relation that you will have to follow is very simple. V of I comma j is 0 provided I is 0, j is 0. No objects, no capacity. Either of the case. Then V of I comma j is equal to V of I minus 1 comma j, means when I try to select the ith object, if the ith object weight is greater than j, so I cannot fill it, isn't it? So what do? I will take the profit of previous object only. That is 1 to I minus 1 objects. So I minus 1. And if at all the profit is less, sorry, the weight is lesser than equal to j, then I should consider 2 scenarios also. What are the 2 scenarios that I have to consider? Selecting the ith object, what profit I get? But not selecting the ith object, what profit I get? Out of those 2, I should select the max value. Maximum of V of I minus 1 comma j. What does this v of I minus 1 comma j indicate for me? It indicates the, what does it indicate, students? It indicates that the ith object is not selected. And what is the profit obtained when it is not selected? Right? And when I add the ith object, what? I added the ith object, so I should remove its weight from the capacity. So j minus w of I. So you have to remember these three recurrence relation to solve the problem. Are you understanding? So let us now see the solution to this problem using dynamic programming, where the items are given in this way: weight, the profit, and the capacity is now 4. Are you understanding? So you have to now construct the profit table. Students, are you there? So we will construct the profit table.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah,
ma'am. Ma'am, the presentation is blurred, ma'am.
Second. Not properly. Right?
Ma'am, it's completely blurred, ma'am, and even your voice is breaking.
About now, okay. Is it one student now? Students, is it visible? Students. How about now? Okay, fine. Okay. So, just moving on to the problem. So, given the problem, the first step here is to generate the profit table. No, what does the profit table says, Ma? What is the profit table? How many rows and how many columns? How many rows and how many columns, students? Someone can answer me. How many rows and how many columns should I consider? Yes, Janvi?
Ma'am, 4 rows, 5 columns, ma'am.
Okay, so 4 rows and 5 columns. How do you justify it is 4 rows and 5 columns? Number of rows is how much? N plus 1. N for me, number of objects. Number of columns is M plus 1. That is the capacity. So capacity is 4 and column related to it, 5. Number of objects is 3, 4 rows. Okay? So consider the table. So I have already values by doing the steps, but initially draw a table which has 4 rows and 5 columns, number is 0 1 2 3 and also 0 1 2 3 4. This is N and this is your M. Are you understanding, right? Is are you all getting? This is your the rows, that is the here, that is M, this is the number of objects. Right, and the rows are indiced with I, with J. Everything, every entry that you put, the sub problem to be solved. They are all overlapping sub problems. Okay, step two is to initialize P of I J equals to 0 where I equals to 0. You all know that. Column will be 0 because J is 0, isn't it? So the first row will be 0 because 0. So I put that. So that V of I comma J is 0 for I equals 0. That is my first row and ranging from 0 to 4. Isn't it? Yes, ma.
Screen is blur again, ma'am.
Okay, 1 second then. Okay, how about now? Is it okay?
No, ma'am.
Okay, now. Is it okay now?
No, ma'am.
Okay, what is the problem? Can anybody share me the screen? How you are getting? Not able to identify what is the problem. about now, students? Is it okay? Okay, can anybody share me the screen, like how you are getting? Because the sheet is bit scan one is bit.
Mom, I've sent you a note, sir.
Yes. The PPT, the PDF screen you just sent me. Someone can send me the PDF screen. I'll just share. Okay. Oh my God, nothing is visible. Earlier it was fine for the Floyds, it was fine.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.